You know, for me today and every moment of Sridevi's, it just takes me back to my entire childhood, my entire being, my passion and love for the movies, my absolute obsession with Hindi cinema. I think she has a large part to do with it. I can't recall the moment where I thought I'd fell madly in love with her. I was just her biggest fan. I just grew up watching. I remember watching her appearance in Julie, and you know, and then went on when she made her big comeback with Himmat.
She had a small role.
Yeah, but Himmatwala was where I remember going with my house help at that time to see Himmatwala in a cinema hall, and because nobody in my immediate surrounding wanted to come with me, and I went multiple times and saw Himmatwala, and then every other movie after that, and I remember literally dancing on a pot and a pan like she had, and this just my love story began with her, and it just never ended. And I remember my father was releasing a film on the same day as Mr. India. He released a film called Mukaddar Ka Faisla, which was directed by a very prolific filmmaker, Prakash Mehra. And my father was very hurt with me because on the opening day, I went running to see Mr. India. I didn't see my father's film. And then Kaate Nahi Katte became my anthem for that whole year. I think it was just her eyes. It was like she spoke like through her eyes. It was just everything from just her eyes, the way she emoted. She just became like... I felt like she was talking to me right through those movies. And I felt every time she moved and she spoke, she had this magical quality of just connecting with you. And she just seemed unattainable, inaccessible, and just the way you want your stars to be, you know. And I just put her up on that pedestal, and she became like every movies of hers. And those movies that no one else saw, I saw. You know, I saw every film of hers. And there used to be these big fights we used to have about who's a bigger Sridevi fan or who's a bigger Madhuri Dixit fan. And I used to take it so personally because it was really... And when Chandni released, like you said, it became my obligation to keep dragging people from college because I was in my first year, junior college at that time at HR, and just wanted them to convert to being a Sridevi fan just the way I was. It just became a personal obsession and a personal mission for me at that point of time. Yes. I would go as far as saying that Sridevi was a genius artist because it takes a lot of genius to do what she did in so many different types of films. And the other thing that we must know about her, she's a rare actor that was on top of her game in all languages at the same time. Whether it was Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, she was on top. A feat no other actor in India has achieved. You know, Anil, for me, I can't even imagine that because, as I said, I've dedicated so much of my childhood just observing, watching and loving her. I may have just lost complete objectivity. You know, I may have given her possibly much more to do than was required of the character. And maybe the film would have suffered as a result. So I'm not sure I would have been the best director for her because I would have been too much of a fan. And I feel somewhere a filmmaker has to be very objective about his or her work. Because I think the moment you lose, and fandom can make you lose objectivity. And I think I would have lost complete objectivity. So I'm glad I never got to direct her because I would have given her a bona fide failure, which she did not deserve.